So what does box plot is actually visual representation of your five statistical numbers. The one who is unmuted can mute himself or herself because the voice is coming louder from their side. So the box plot is the visual representation of the statistical five number of summary given on the data set. That means the box plot always represents your statistical data generally in the form of your box, and that is why it has been said to be a box plot, because you are using it into the form of box. That means you are representing it into the form of box. Now generally it represents five values of your data. One is your minimum value, maximum value, your first quartile, third quartile, and a median of it. So generally these 5 points are summarized in your box plot. So whenever you want to summarize any of your 5 points, that is minimum, maximum, or any of the quartile, you can always go with the box plot. It will look always like this. This is the appearance of your box plot. It is said to be the box plot because its appearance is like a box. That's why it has been referred to as a box plot. So let's see how do we use, or how do we do it in Python? How do we create the box plot in the Python? So for creating the box plot in the Python, what are you going to do is, your syntax for it is that you are going to use with your library. Instead of this, you can always use whatever the acronym you have given for it. Like if I give PLT, which I have given in all the slides, you can also write like PLT.boxplot. Again, repeating that for line, we use dot plot. For scatter, we use dot scatter. For bar graph, we use dot bar. For histogram, we use dot hist, and in the way box plot, for box plot, we use dot box plot. Now, if you're drawing box plot, the arguments will be inside. There are so many arguments listed over here. So we'll go through them one by one. So first of all, your x. What is x? Is your array of sequence of vectors. That means whatever the data has been given, that will be considered as your x. Second option, second argument we have is our not. Now see, one more thing you will notice, that all the arguments whichever are there is having a boolean value. Now for your revision, boolean says it can be the true or it can be the false. If and the numerical representation of true and false is, for true we usually write 1, for false we write 0. So if you want that whatever the box has been shown up should also show not, then in that case, if you want notch to be represented, you can always write notch is equal to true. So if you write true in the box plot, your notch will appear. Now you will be wondering about it, how do the notch look like? So we'll see it in the programs itself, that how does the notch look like. Next argument we have is vert. Vert says we want your box to be in vertical position or horizontal position. So if you want it into the vertical position, you can always pass the value as true. So if it is true, it will make it into the vertical position. If it is false, it will draw it horizontally. By default, it is always true. If you do not mention, by default, your box plot will be in vertical way. Next, we have is our mean line, which says that, do you want to show the mean line? They are going to find the mean also, because there are five statistical data which they are going to represent, in which one of the point is your mean median. So do you want to represent it? If you want to represent it, you can always write mean line is equal to 2. If you write that, it will appear. If you don't write that, it will not appear. Show boxes, that whatever the box plot we are drawing, it will be showing you a box. If you do not want that box to look like, but you want only the 5 points to be visible, you can always write this. This is optional. Everything is optional. It all depends on you. Do you want to use it or not? Next is your show mean. Show means is also the same. Do you want to show the arithmetic mean of it? If you want to show, then you can always pass true. If you do not want, you can pass false for it. So let's see how does it happen into the programming part. So there are three programs for us put on this slide. First of the slide will be that we have to create a simple data box. So first of all, for creating even a simple data box, what we are going to do, we are going to have import, first of all, your matplot library. Because since we are working on our matplot library, that's why we will be since you are working on box plot and it is involved in matplot library, pyplot module, that's why we will be importing first of all that. If you do not import, it will throw you an error. So first of all, we will import it and then we will pass the data. As our slide was saying, that the data should be passed first. So for passing the data, you should have a data log with it. So this is our data, which is referred to be as X in the slide, and we are naming it as AR1. So this is our array of data. Now I have given the title with the help of method title. So plot.title is being used for giving the title of your plot. So the title is plain box plot. That means I'm drawing simple a box plot without using any of the argument inside it. I have just simply passed the data. None of the argument has been passed. You can see there are so many arguments, but I have not passed a single argument. So let's see what happens. As I run this program, the output will be like this. You can see that in the output, nothing has been drawn up. Nothing has been drawn up that indicates that no mean points has been shown up, and it is by default vertically. As I saw, told you that if you do not mention vertical position, it will be by default in your vertical position. Similarly, if we want to show our mean, that I want this line stands for mean and median, but it is not showing any point along with it, that this is the mean. But if you want that the mean should be shown up, we always have an argument saying show means. Everything else is same. Only one argument I have added that says show means is equals to true. So you can see that the pointer is appearing over here. That is indicating your mean. Here, no pointer was there, but here pointer was there, and it is indicating that it is a mean. Next we have is if you want not. Now, what is not actually, you can see in the picture. That notch is this, all the picture is also changed, and that is set to be as your notch. If you write notch is equal to true, the box shape will change into the notch shape. It will not be similar. So as you say notch is equal to true, it will get converted into this way. The box plot will get converted to the notch shape. So here, what three arguments I have passed, that array should be there because you have to draw the box plot of array. Show means is equal to true is quite optional. Do you want to put it or not? If you put it, you can see this green kind of pointer over there. Notch is equal to true is going to change your shape like this in form of notch. So this is how your notch is working. So these are the three arguments which I have discussed. Let's see other arguments. How does it work? So there are more arguments other than this. One is notch is there. And then this one more additional argument has been added, which is your vertical is equal to false. See, by default, I was telling you that by default, if you do not write, it is vertically is equal to true. Now, since you are mentioning it over here, vertical should be equal to false, and notch is also true. That's why the shape is also like that. Mean is also visible, and now we can see that the notch has been converted to vertical shape. You can see that in your previous slide, it was in horizontal. But since we have written an argument saying vert, what stands for vertical. So if you write vertical equals to false, you can see that this has been converted into your horizontal shape. Similarly, we have one more thing which is if it says show box. If I do not want to see the box of it, but only wanted to see the 5 points associated with it. So what are the 5 points? That minimum, then maximum, then first quartile, third quartile, and this median. So I can see all the 5 points, but I am not able to see box because I have put in attribute that show box should be equals to false. So I'll explain you all the 4-5 arguments which can possibly go inside the box plot. If you do not want to use it, it is not compulsory. You can simply write plt.boxplot and then pass your data inside it. But definitely, at least you have to pass your data. If you will not pass the data, the box will not be printed. Next we have is we can come see till the time we were seeing only example of one single box plot. But you can draw many box plots also. That as we were doing in line and all, that we could draw 2-3 lines, 2-3 boxes, 2-3 histograms. In the similar way, we can do it with the box plot also. So if you want to draw 2-3 or 4 box plot, how can you draw it? You can draw it using this. You can see the example that we have value 1 as this, value 2, value 3, and value 4. There are 4 values given inside this. I wanted to print the box plot for all 4 of them. So what can I do here? I can just pass all the 4 data inside this. Now see, while we were drawing 2 lines or 2 boxes, not 2 boxes, but 2 bars, we were using the same function twice, like plt.plot and the data. Then again, plt.plot the data. If 2 lines are there, we were writing it 2 times. If 3 lines were there, we were writing the function 3 times. But that is not so in the case of box plot. Here you can pass the list of the data together over here. And also you can specify just once whether you do you want it in the vertical position or not. Now see, they have written one. As I told you before that these are the Boolean arguments where false always stands for zero and true always stands for one. It is like universal now that false means zero, true means one. So if I mention vertical is equal to one, that means they're saying vertical is equal to true. So that means your box plot will come into your vertical position. Now you can, along with the box plot, one more thing which you can do is, which we can do in all the functions, like for plotting the line and for everything, that you can pass the labels over here. Now the first label will be associated with first value one. Second label will be associated with label two. Third will be with third. Fourth will be with fourth. Do not get confused that which one will be associated with which one. So it is like all the data will be associated with one another, line by line. So this is how your box plots work. Now see, I have just added one of the square blocks over here which says page underscore artist. Now see, there are not only this four or five attributes in the box plot. There are many attributes which are possible inside the box plot. But since that are not in our syllabus, we'll not be going too far with reading all the attributes, because every function has so many attributes associated with it. But we are reading only those attributes, or trying to read only those which are actually covered in your textbook. But just for your information, there is one page underscore artist attribute is there, which also takes Boolean value true or false. So if you include a page underscore artist equals true, by default it will color your all the box plot, and it will be colored in your blue color, because the default color is your blue. So by default it will cover your all the box plot into blue color. Is it clear? Any doubts till now? Because this is what our box plot is. Box plot was very easy. You might get the questions of giving the data will be given to you, and they will be asking you to create box plot and having the showing the mean, or not showing the box, or having the notch in it. So this type of questions you might find it in the exam, or they will give you a box plot picture and they will ask you to write the code for it. So in that case, you should be sufficient to write the code. They will be definitely giving you the data, but they might give you this kind of picture and will be asking you that how many attributes are being used in this box plot. It might come in 2 to 3 marks, because only 3-4 lines you have to draw for it, and especially the main line includes this because it has blue. That means means has been shown up. Then it is a different shade. That means notch is equal to true. Then it is in horizontal position. That means vertical is equal to false. So that all you have to figure out that what all possible attributes has been passed over this. So moving on to now pie charts. As you must be aware that what pie chart is. Pie chart is a circular representation of your all the data. It generally represents your all the data in form of your percentage. And it divides all of your data categorically in the equal proportions and percentage, or whatever the proportion has been given to it, it will transfer into draw it into that form. So now for drawing a pie chart, we have the syntax as plot plt. You already know why I'm writing this. I'm not repeating it again. Plt.py. Pi is the function which is being used to draw your pie chart. Now the data will be passed will be x, which says that whatever the array do you want, whatever the data do you want, whatever the sizes, that means here do you want to draw, then the labels. Because if I draw a pie chart, if I divide the pie chart into 4 or 5 pies, but I do not know the name of it, that I don't know that 70% occupies IP or 10% occupies PE, but I know 70, 10, 80, 30 is the data, then it's like no use. Because I don't know what are the labels of it. So labels are a kind of must that should go on, because then only we can decide that which particular part pie represents what. Colors is optional. You can always pass the color into it. Now this is something new to you all, that auto PCT is equals to this. Now see, Python library takes the format this. The format will be the same. You cannot change the format while writing this. Now what does it say? That whenever you are representing your data in the form of percentage, the percentage, how the percentage should be represented, it shows this. So if I'm writing 0.1, that indicates that your percentage should be there, and after the decimal in the percentage, at least one number should be shown up. Suppose it's 60% is there, then it will not take 60%, But since it is given 0.1, that means there should be at least one decimal value after your main percentage, so like 60.1, 60.2, something like that. If I mention over here 0.2 or something, that indicates that it will be taking your two decimal values after that. So this was your all four labels. What does it say? We'll see into the programming part. There are some more labels or some more attributes associated with this. One is first of discussing with the first one. So the first one we have is our explode. Now, what does it say? Explode says means taking out a particular pie or showing it differently outside the complete circle pie. So explode can take an array kind of value which will be equal to the length of the element. Suppose if X is having four elements, then explode will also have your four elements. So if you pass your four elements, it should have a value that how do you want your pie to look like? Do you want your one pie to come out like and shown up differently? Or do you want the pie, different pies to be in different shape, different kind of exploded form? It will get clear to you into the picture as I'll show you how the explode works. It will be better clear to you there. Next, we have a shadow, which says that do you want the shade or not? It is a Boolean input in which by default it is false. So if you want that, the pie which is being appeared should at least look like a bit 3D or the shader should appear, it will look better. Then you can always write shadow is equal to true. Then we have start angle. You can always define the angle from the x-axis, that from where do you want to start. Suppose if I write x is equal to 90, suppose start angle is equal to 90, then my pie will start drawing from 90 degree. That means the first element will be from your 90 degree. Counterclockwise is again Boolean. That means again takes true or false only. Default it is true, that means it will always start drawing your pie chart into anti-clockwise direction. If you write here false, then it will start into the clockwise direction. Then coming on to the radius, you can always, if you see that, if you feel like your pie is smaller, is visible small or is small in size, then you can always increase the radius of it. By default, the radius, if you are not giving, it is set to 1. But if you want that, my pie chart should be a bigger one, then you can always increase the size of it. So you can always use the function radius inside the, and you can always use attribute radius inside this pie function. So you can see the example over here. We were having the values which we need to draw and the labels that US should be of 60, UK should be of 80, India should be of 90, like this. Now I have given colors array also, that I want all the pie should be in different color. So I'll be mentioning here over colors also. Now see here, explode. Now what does it explode says? 0.2, 0. Now see, first of all, when you are mentioning your explode, its value should be same as the length of the array. The array we were having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 values are there. So 6 value should also pass into the explode. So let's see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now see, what does explode say is, you can see the first value of US should be exploded by 0.2. So you can see that the 60 has been popped out 0.2. This is what your explode says. Others are all 0, 0, 0. That's why it is intact into this. But if you write explode, it comes out like this. One of the pi you are mentioning that it should be 0.2 exploded. So you can see the output, how does it look like. Now let's draw the pie. So plot that pie, value should be inserted over it, color should be given, labels should be given, explode should be given. Now the another which we have is your counter clock is equal to false. Now what I was saying, that counter clock is by default true, but if you mention false, it will start in your clockwise direction. That means this is your x-axis and it will start below this. If counterclockwise is false, maximum limit to explode, no, you can write whatever you want. You can try it out how maximum it can go. But it generally takes, you can see that 0.2 has already exploded this much. We can definitely try it into the program that how much more explode can be done. But as such, there is no maximum limit defined for it. Okay, so counterclock means that we are going to move clockwise. So you can see this is our X and they have said that the counterclockwise is equal to false. That means they will not go in this direction, but they will move inside this direction. So the first pie will be drawn in this direction. Now shadow is equals to true. That means shadow is equals to true. You can see over here pi. This is the small little bit shadow which can be appeared. You can see here also a bit 3D look will be given to it since shadow is equals to true has been given. Now legends has been given because label has already been defined. So you can always give a legend over here. You already I'm repeating it one more time for those who might not have attended the lecture. That if you are writing a legend, you always need to mention the labels in your function. If you do not mention the label, it will not plot your legends like this. So now see, only the difference is they have passed their labels over here. If you do not even pass the labels, it will by default take these labels from there and you can just specify your location. Now location is equals to 3 says because 1 location is here, 2 location is over here, 3 location is over here and the 4th one is over here. So if you say location is equal to 3, you can see that the output will be visible on this side. And then plot dot show. So you can clearly see that how does it look like. Now there are some more attributes which I have added over here, which says that you have the same thing are there, but the attributes are like. So before you can see that it is not mentioned into the percentage. You can see the values are written simply like that. Whatever the values are there has been shown in the pi as it is. But what if you want it into the percentage? So we already know that if you want to show your values into the percentage, there is an attribute saying auto PCT will be equals to whatever the format is there. So format is that percentage should be there. Then you should mention how many point values do you need after decimal. And then float, since it is a floating point value, so F will be there and then percentage. So you can see over here in the output only 1% after per decimal, only one value has been shown up. They have calculated the percentage on the basis of this and then they have just shown you the percentage like this. Only one point is there. You can always increase it. Now counter clock is equal to false. That means again it will say that it is going to be clockwise. So it will start from here. Start angle is equal to 140. That means if your angle is changed, that means you have to start your values from 140. I can show it into the programming. Just let me share the spider. One second. See, for a box plot, I was telling you that it can always be drawn into the blue picture. So for that, you just have to write batch underscore artist is equals to true. So in that way, all the box plot will get converted to blue color because it is the default color. But in case if you want to add color, there is a for loop for it and there are many other functions also with it which will be used, which is not currently near syllabus. So rather than not wasting time, we'll move on to the pie chart. This was our pie chart. Okay, we'll just run this pie chart. I hope you can see my spider screen.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, it has been shared. Okay, so you can see over here that the values are given, colors are given, labels are given. Suppose if I write my explode as 0.6 and I run it, so you can see the pi has been exploded out with 0.c. Let's try it with some integer values. I don't know what is the maximum limit because it is not defined anywhere. But if you do so, see there is no limit for it. You can see if I have written 6, it goes like this. So there is no limit for defining it. So let's change it to 0.1 and see how does it get exploded. So it will get back to its position. Suppose if I want this also to get exploded, I do not want it like this, but I want it like this. And let's see how does it look like now. So you can see that that particular fourth point, that means we are talking about Germany. Germany is also exploded with 0.4 value. So this is how your explode works. I hope it might be clear to you now how the explode function works. Now see, talking about the autopsy, if I write over here, I do not want one decimal, but I want 4 decimal values after it. Let's see what will be the output for it. So you can see each is having 4 values after it. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is how your 4 values, 4 floating points can be visible to you. Now suppose what if I change the front integer from 1 to 2? What do you think? Does it make any difference? There will be no as such difference because this format just take the floating points value that how much more do you want to represent after decimal. So see, before when 1 was there, the same output was there. 2 was there, still the same output is there. only the output is changing when you are showing that how many points values do you want. Suppose I want only 3, then we can just go with the 3-point decimal values. You can see that the output has been changed like this. Now you can see a little bit of shadow has been appearing over here. But if I write shadow is equals to false, I do not want the shadow over here. Now see one more thing. If you write any of the string, generally it comes into your quotes. But here I am not writing false into the quotes because it is a keyword. Now you can see no shadow is there. You cannot see, it is just a plain picture. So that is what your shadow is equal to true says. Okay, so let's just run it. You will see again the difference. You can see now the shadow has been popped out. A little bit of shadow is already is visible. Now see, if I write counter clock is equals to true, within all the pictures I've shown you that the counter clock is equals to false. Suppose if I don't write it first, then by default it is true only. So let's just delete it from here for now and let's see the output. The output will be almost same because already I have mentioned the counter clockwise is equals to true because by default it is the same. But what if what if I write over here false and no starting angle for now, so that at least it will get clear to you that how does it work. We are running out of time, but we are not left with anyway more slides. So if I write counter clock is equals to false, so how does the pi will change? Now you can see counter clockwise is equal to false and first one is our US. So now this is our X axis and from here everything starts. So if I write counter clock is equals to false, what will happen from this X axis, it will move downwards. So for moving downwards, the first one will be our US. So the first US will come like this. Archit is having a doubt. Can we write zero there before decimal point in the auto PCT? That is completely fine. Can we try with 200.4 for what? Can we try with 200.4 for explode? Let's see, I have not tried out such disaster things. Let's see how does it work if you are talking about the explode. Okay, what to PCT? Oh, it's not working. Just wait a minute. For auto PCT, you want me to drive with 200.4. Where is my auto PCT? But anyway, I'm telling you that it won't work with Python has stopped working. Just a minute. Your Python has stopped working because of your 200.4 explode. It is exploding so much that the Python is even stopped. Okay. So by the time our Python again gets started, we'll just finish up our remaining slides, which says how to save plots. The other disaster things, you can try it out at your home because then if like this, because my spider has stopped working. I'll just check one more time if the spider has started. Yeah, Aditya. Okay, Python has stopped working. I have to close it right now. Share screen. Okay, I'm going with for now saving of the plot because we are done with all the attributes over here. The only attribute which is remaining to show you was a start angle. So start angle is equal to 140 says that from 140 degree, your angle will start actually. Your first at first value will plot. If you write start angle is equal to 140 or 90 or 80, whatever do you write, after that, the first US or your first US value will get printed. Now see, here the picture is depicting a pie chart which is having not a start angle is 140. Might be I have taken a different, pasted a different output over here. But if you write start angle equals to 140, its output will be quite different. You can try it in your own systems now because my spider is not working. Or maybe we can rejoin the meeting just to see that how does it the different changes work out. Once it gets started. Now, the last one we have in the series is to save plots. Now see, till the time we are just running it. So if we are running it, we can see the plots over there in the programs itself. But what if I want to save that plot? I want to use that in some of the website, or I want to show it somewhere on the screen. So if I want to save the plot, there are the method which has been used, that is plot.saveFigure. Inside that, the argument which will pass on will be your name of the file. Now, whatever the plot you want to save, you can save it into different formats. Like you can save it into the .png, then you can save it into the .pdf, or you can save it in any other form, whichever you want. So like you can, if you want to save it into .pdf, you just have to mention .pdf, .svg, whatever the JPEG or PNG, whatever the image you want to save into. Now see, I have not mentioned the address. If you will not mention the address, it will get by default saved to the location where your pie chart pie files are being saved, or whatever the current directory you are working in. But if you do not want them to save into the current directory, but you want a specific location, you can always save. See, I wanted to save it into my E drive where I have an IP folder, in which I wanted to save into the chapters folder, matlib folder, then into this form I wanted to save it. So I can just name the file. You can save it with .png. And this way you can save your file. This is a basic way to save your file. But if there are so many attributes associated with it. So there are some of the attributes which we'll be discussing as. So if you save figure, there are the attributes like, first of all, you have to give the file name. If you want to save it into the current directory, just give the file name. But if you want to save it with the particular address, then you can give the address as I have mentioned it over here. Now DPI, which says dot per inches, you can always specify it is for the image quality. Face color is equals to W, says that whatever the plot you are drawing, you can specify any of the color. If you do not specify the color, it will by default come into the W, that means white. Edge color can be defined, transparency can be defined. Now see, some of the time what happens when you save your figure, by default the figure has been like compressed, or it's half of the portion has been cut down, or something like this happens while saving the figure. So if you use this bbox_inches is equals to none, it will definitely none. Instead of none, it should be tight. Tight should be used instead of that. So in that way, the complete plot picture will be saved in a good way. And nothing will be cut short, but exact picture will be saved. Now in that case, if you're using bbox inches, you can also use pad_inches is equals to 0.1, which will just increase your pad size. Suppose if this is my plot, this white plot, then this is your pad size. So if you want pad inches to increase, you can just add this one more feature, one more attribute, which will increase your pad size. This is the same which I wrote. Tight, I was saying, this is T-I-G-H-T is the spelling for that. Now this is one of the example where I'm saving a figure. Everything is same. This is, I have example of line. I have taken example of plotting a line, which already I explained it before. Just jumping onto the main point, which is of a save figure. So in plotting.save figure, what will happen? I can just write the name of this. I can mention DPI, transparency, bbox, and face color. Everything is optional. If you do not write anything and just save it like this, your figure will get saved. So you can see, when I do not mention any of the, when I mention the location, it will go to the same location. I can see the location over there and the line_float. If I do not mention it, it will by default go to the spider folder where my all .py files are being saved by default. It will be saved over there. So once, if you mention the address, it will go to the particular address. If you do not mention the address, it will go to the current directory you're working in. Now see, while using this attributes, there are so many changes which happens, which I cannot show you now because we are running out of the time. Or else we can just do one more thing. We can again start it. Okay, before doing that, I'll just go to the spider to see if it's working now. So by the time I have spider open, I'll just show you the general questions for your box and pie. There are only two questions which will be there for your journal. This has not been shared now again. Share. Okay, these are our journal questions. Only two questions is there. One is to draw your pie chart. Values are already given. Labeling is already given. And you have to save the figure in JPG format at any specified position. If you want some particular location, you can do it. If you do not want, you can do not use it. Just use the CU figure function. One question is, you have to draw a box plot which should be in horizontal orientation. You have to show its mean and its title should be this horizontal box plot. And its y-axis title should be value ring. So using this, you have to use this two more questions for your journal. So by the time, I guess we are done with 26 to 27 journal questions. I hope you are doing it at your home. And okay, so now Spider is open. I will just share it with you. Oh, Spider. Still not open. Okay, just wait. By the time. Any more doubts, then please ask me the doubts if you have any doubts. By the time I'm trying to share, okay, this is my Spider screen. Hope you are able to see. So we were working on, just a minute. We are left with less than 1 minute, but we'll see this how we're working. So we were working on this autopicity, counterclockwise is equal to false, shadow is equal to true. Shadows equals to false. So let's run this.